Hey guys, Kyle again from ePoolSupply. Today we are back with a comparison video for you guys on Pentair's IntelliFlo3 1.5 horsepower pump and their original SuperFlo VST 1.5 horsepower pump. Stay tuned. All right, guys, and we're back. So again, we're gonna do a quick little comparison video for you guys. If you haven't seen the video explaining a lot of the features that this one has, you guys can go ahead and check out the links down in the description. But for this video, I wanna kind of just have them side by side for you guys so that you guys can actually see what the original model of the SuperFlo VST, which is part number 342002, and the new IntelliFlo3 1.5 horsepower that is model 011065. So, right off the bat, you guys can see that there are some major changes in the design that they did. Right off the bat, we'll talk about the front. So obviously you guys can see that the inlets are the same height, but you can tell that the volutes are slightly different. So the IntelliFlo3 is going to have a little bit of a larger volute, which just allows that water to come in a little bit better, just a better flow overall for your equipment compared to the original SuperFlo. And then in my opinion, I really love the design that they did with the IntelliFlo3 of the actual clear lid being a part of this entire ram and clamp that they actually put on here. Whereas with the SuperFlo, you're going to have to replace that inner clear lid because over time, obviously that thing becomes dingy and it's difficult to see if there's debris in there. So it does allow you to actually replace that compared to this one. But quality wise, I really love the bigger handles on this one point on the IntelliFlo3 just because it's going to be an easier open and close for you, rather than these smaller pieces on the SuperFlo ram and clamp. So that's your first part. The baskets are nearly identical. I'd say that they definitely updated some of the plastics that they used on the new one compared to the old one. It feels a little bit thicker, but other than that, it's typically the exact same size to catch all that different debris. And then you'll notice that I don't actually have unions on this one, but the same unions that are used for the original SuperFlo are also the ones that are used on the IntelliFlo3 1.5 horse. So again, you're going to hear me say that really long name, but it's just part of the series. IntelliFlo3 is the newer style pump. And then I do have to differentiate it for you guys, knowing that it's a horse and a half compared to their 3-horsepower model, whereas this used to be called the SuperFlo, and then the 3-horse model was an IntelliFlo. So that's where those two differences come into play with that. So bear with me as I say the name 5 times, it gets a little longer. But outside of the unions being swappable for you guys, which I really think is cool, they both work for 1.5 or 2-inch pipe. You can do 1.5 inside, 2-inch outside. Definitely highly recommend anytime you're installing your actual IntelliFlo or SuperFlo that you guys use your unions. Try not to go directly into the pump. It just makes it a nightmare if anything does happen with it, and the serviceability that you can have with actually using a pair of unions will save you a ton of money down the road, especially time if you're the one having to do all the plumbing for it. So again, both of these are only available at a retail. They do make an e-commerce version of the SuperFlo, so you guys can actually check that out. That's actually a different model. It doesn't have quite the software that this one does in front of me, but identical in look. So again, check out the links in the description. We'll have all those things for you guys. But so aside from the unions, as you guys make your way back on the actual motor end of the pump, you guys can see a huge difference with the motor. This is a true 1.5 horse. These ones did not have that technology at the time. And even though they're classified as a 1.5 horse, when you actually run this thing at full speed, you're almost up to a 2.2 horsepower. So it actually gives you more horsepower out of these, but these are going to run more efficient. So when you're looking at the actual variable speed aspect, this is going to actually run better for you over time and save you more money in the long term compared to this one, especially if you're having to run it at that higher speed. Now, when you're toning them back and you're running them at much lower RPMs, you're not going to see much of a difference in the energy savings aspect. But when it comes to the longevity of the motor itself, you're going to see a lot more out of the newer style compared to the older one, just with the fact that it's a better made motor. So that's a big piece as well. And then right on the top, you guys will notice here is this one does not have a screen, whereas this one has a screen. So one big feature they made with the IntelliFlo3 version is that they made it screenless here, where you actually have the ability to go fully automated from the pump itself. So No panel needed on the wall, no extra piece of equipment. You hook this thing up, you scan this QR code on top, you flip your little antenna up right here on the side, you run through, you get your schedules made, everything connected. Now you can access this pump at any time when you're within Bluetooth range, or if you hook it up to your Wi-Fi, wherever you're at in the world, you can actually have access as long as this has a good connection to your Wi-Fi connection. So awesome, awesome technology that they're putting into these things, allowing you guys for those single pump systems where you don't have a ton of other things that you want to operate. Really, really, really cool that you can do all those things from this newer stop. So I would say the one downfall is being able to do some stuff at the pump itself, especially for a service aspect. You want to be able to come up to it. Maybe you need to adjust the schedules. So when your service guy shows up, it does make it a little bit more difficult if they don't have access into this pump, which they can scan it, Bluetooth it, and try to get into some of the stuff. But overall, it's a lot easier when you're wanting to just manually quickly do something from this screen comparatively. So again, though, same thing. This one can do a ton of schedules. This one's only set to 3 schedules. You do have a quick clean button on both pumps. And then obviously this one has just your on and off, which this one has the start and stop. And there's also a connect button on the new one, which actually just lets you know that you're connected to the application or you're connected to automation. So there is a different button there. So, but again, now as you move your way back kind of farther into the pump on the IntelliFlo3, you'll notice that it's a 0 clearance pump. So you don't actually have to leave room for your fan because there's an overhang here for the power connections to actually allow that fan to still have enough room to cool that motor off. So you don't actually have to have a clearance section off your wall, off of your other equipment, whatever it may be. So you can butt this thing right up to whatever it is, your brick wall, your other pump, your filter, whatever it is, and that short amount of space you have over there by your equipment. And this thing will still operate without the risk of overheating because of this. So that's really nice. Whereas with these ones, you do have to leave that room so that it gives that opportunity for that fan to bring in that cool air to cool these motors down. So that's one big part. And then again, if you guys want to check out the video for this, I kind of go into more detail. There's an opportunity for you to install another I/O board on the back, which will allow you to actually work with 2 other devices, whereas this one does not have that capability. And the fact that this one is just more update. You're just the updated version of this is going to operate for you way more efficiently compared to this one. Again, this is still a great pump. But if you're looking for that newest technology, highly recommend you go on with that IntelliFlo3. But outside of that, that's pretty much all the comparisons that we can see from our point. Again, the automation aspect, the baskets. I did miss the point that you will end up having to replumb this inlet that goes to your filter just because these distances are not the same. So if you're replacing this SuperFlow with this new IntelliFlo3, you can line up through your front piece, no problem. But when you come back to this other piece of having to go to the actual filter, this piece is going to have to get replumbed because there is a difference in space between the front and the back here on the balut. So you'll definitely have to replumb that, but that's actually better than having to completely replumb everything. So again, just wanted to kind of go over the differences for you guys on Pentair's new IntelliFlo3 1.5 horsepower and their original SuperFlow VST pump, which is also a 1.5 horsepower. So again, check out the description below. We've got a ton of other stuff down there for you guys. Come check out the website. And then of course you can always contact us if you have any other further questions. But I really appreciate you guys watching. Till next time, I'm Kyle from ePoolSupply.
Thanks for watching our videos. Be sure to like and subscribe down below. We have a lot more content coming up. I'm Greg with ePoolSupply. See you next time.